This video shows how to test the assumption of homogeneity of covariances for a mixed ANOVA and SPSS. First, let me explain what this actually is. Homogeneity of covariances is an abbreviation for the homogeneity of covariances of the between subject factor, aka the group. Or put another way, the covariance matrices for the groups have to be roughly equal. A common test for homogeneity of covariances is Box's M-test. Its null hypothesis assumes homogeneity of the covariance matrices, which means that it is better not to reject the null hypothesis. However, Box's M-test is prone to inaccuracies if the sample size is too large or too small, or if the normal distribution assumption is violated. It is therefore advised to proceed with caution and to use a lower alpha value than usual. The Box's M-test can be included in the calculation of the mixed ANOVA, but must be explicitly requested via Analyze, General Linear Model, Repeated Measures. The within subject factor name and its number of levels need to be defined first. Then the within subject variables and between subjects factor are then assigned accordingly. Under Options, check the Homogeneity Tests box and perform the calculation by clicking Next and OK. The result is being displayed right after the counts for the between subjects factors. The focus here should be on the p-value. I have already mentioned that the usual alpha thresholds of 0.05 or 0.01 should be avoided in favor of an even stricter value of 0.001, especially with sample sizes above 100. In my example, the p-value of 0.11 is large enough and the null hypothesis cannot be rejected. If the null hypothesis of homogeneity of covariances is rejected, one consequence could be that the results for the interaction term are misleading. If you reject the null hypothesis, you should first check for normal distribution of the test variable per group and time point, if this has not already been done, as non-normal distribution can lead to a significant Box's test. The usual measures can be taken if you have no approximate normal distribution, although bootstrapping is not possible for this procedure in SPSS. And there are no non-parametric or robust variants and only a transformation of the test variable is possible. Alternatively, you can continue with the mixed ANOVA and point out that the assumption of covariance homogeneity is not fulfilled and that there is a potentially higher probability of alpha and beta errors. In my example, I can assume that the covariance matrices are reasonably equal and proceed with my mixed ANOVA or check the other necessary assumptions.